Hello and welcome to Robot Vlog 2. Lots of progress this week. I've actually gotten really far. Well, I mean, far along relative to how huge this project is. So I guess I can just show you what I've done so far. So in this little doc that I made, basically I found a website, a NASA government website, which had all of the like 50th percentile sizes for different parts of your anatomy. So it gave me all the measurements of the average person. So basically I've got all the knowledge on how people are, including range of motion, stuff like that. And what I can do with that, and what I did do with that, is for my model, I created some parametric variables which had equations which basically converted what I had for the total height of my robot. So right now I'm tentatively at 45 centimeters, so like almost half a meter tall, so he's a pretty big boy. And basically it converts this measurement, its height, and from that I can calculate the different body part lengths. So for example, knee height. If we go over to the NASA thing, which I think knee height is sitting. Knee height sitting 529, so it's that measurement from the ground up to the top of the knee. And basically, since I know that the 50th percentile of people have a knee height of 56.7, I can convert that to my robot's knee height using the ratio of the average like total height that I'm aiming for, which is 45 centimeters underneath the average height of 179.9 centimeters, and I can just convert that, so now I can find my knee height of 56.7, or of 141 centimeters, or millimeters, I mean. Numbers. So it's the measurement of the average knee height, or the knee height of like 50th percentile, yada yada, divided by 179 over the height that I'm calculating for. And that gives me my actual one. And then if we go into the model here, let me just get rid of that quickly. Basically I made some sketches to kind of mimic that. So like this is that knee height. And if I were to change the parametrics, so if I'm like, oh, I want it to be short. I want it to only be 30 centimeters tall. I hit that and everything updates, and suddenly it's smaller. But I do want it 45, so I'm going to change it back. Boop, boop, boop. And now it's back to the full big size. Now if you're pretty good at seeing things, you'll notice that I've got a model in here now. So basically this is the leg, which I'm trying to work on. So it's got quite a few different joints that I've labeled. So we've got like the hip. I'm still missing the twisty part of the hip, but basically we've got the quad type area. So this is the hip part there. And then this is your knee, and then this is your ankle, and then your foot would be down here. So I've just been messing around with that. I've actually 3D printed a small portion of it. I've 3D printed the quad area just to kind of get a better idea of the scale, because I always struggle looking at the 3D model. So this is my little quad that would go boop. So that's exciting. This is super early design, so I'm going to be remaking it with like cable routing and bearings and all that stuff. But for now, I'm just trying to get an idea of the layout, how far things are separated. If I put this servo here, will I still have enough rotational freedom so that it can move like a human? So that's kind of what I've got going on with the leg right now. I've got these two connector pieces that I'm working on. So I guess now we can move on to the other thing that I've been working on besides just the design, which is the budget. So I made a little slideshow. Oh no, let's not start. So the next thing we can move on to is the budget. So I made a little slideshow going over all the different components and with their amount of money you'd expect to spend. So the most expensive thing, of course, is the servo motors. And the reason why it's more expensive is because you need a lot of them. So each one is only like $27, but when you're getting 22, you kind of end up with $600 of servo motors, which is a lot. So of course I've got the conversions for other money types, just so if you're from somewhere else, you can just easily see that. Next up, we've got the battery, which is again around $27. Generally for this whole project, components seem to like being around $30-ish. Of course, if you're American, it's cheaper, but you also have a really low minimum wage, so. So battery around $27. For the microcontroller, I haven't 100% decided on which one to use, so I decided to average around $100. You can get a lot cheaper, you can get a lot more expensive. Maybe it'll be around that area. Right now, I just ordered a Teensy, which is the green one, to try it out because you can overclock them to be really fast, which I think would be funny. And then the other ones, the one in the middle that's black, that's the Arduino Portenta, like L5 or H7 or something like that. Really, really great name. That's one that I actually have right now, but that one's like $150, which is nuts. But basically, that the feature that makes that one cool is it's got two processors, so it can do real-time stuff, which, if you know what that is, you get a gold star. And then, of course, we've just got a basic Arduino Nano there, which is like $50-ish. Actually, what's surprising is the Teensy is pretty cheap, but the place that I bought it from, the shipping was expensive. So a Teensy, depending on where you're getting it from, could only be around $40-ish, which is a really good deal. So if you can, as long as it works with your project, I'd suggest that. And I hope it works for my project, but we'll find out, I guess. Next up, we've got servo driver. A lot of different options. I kind of chose went with the cheapest one that was fast shipping, which is this one. Maybe eventually when I'm done the whole project, I'll have an actual tally of how much I spent, and then with like links and stuff like that. But for now, it's this one. It's around $32. Next, we've got the IMU, which stands for Inertial Measurement Unit. This thing is really for, basically it's kind of like a robotic inner ear. So it lets the robot know if it's turning or rotating, and then it can also measure the acceleration. So if you like kick the robot, it'll realize it's been kicked. The one that I'm getting has 9 degrees of sensing. So it's got like all the different rotations, all the different measurements for acceleration. And then I think it's got some weird like magnetism stuff that I'm probably not gonna use, but why not have it? The reason why I chose the one that I did is because a guy who I'm basing the design of the robot off of, he used it, and I really liked what his was capable of, so I just thought I would copy that. Next up, we've got voltage converter. So I think I went over this earlier in the other video. Basically, it just changes the voltage lower. This one was about $33, but you are getting a pack of 10 because that's the only way you can buy them for some reason. I'm trying to be more transparent than other videos that people make where it's like, oh, it's so cheap, but they're including for the cost of just one, but often you can't buy just one. So I'm just trying to be like, this is actually what you spend, not what you could spend if you were making 10 of them. So I don't know. I hope that'll be helpful. Battery connectors. This is so you can connect your battery to your DC, your voltage converter directly, as opposed to just soldering it, which is not good practice. And this is, again, I think it's like a pack of 5 matching female male sets. So again, more than you'll need, but who knows, you'll probably find another project to use them for. Next up, we got some radio stuff. Again, I'm still undecided. I've got like an RC transmitter that can go really far. I don't know if I'm going to use that or not, or if I'm going to use like a custom controller. It's really up in the air. I just ordered some cheap Amazon radio transmitters that you can use with Arduinos. So if I do decide to do a custom one, I can. But again, I don't know what I'm doing with that yet. So it's probably going to be more than this. But for now, $13. Of course, extras. This is a very undervalued additional amount, which again, in the end, I'll have a better number. But for now, I'm just saying $50. And that's for like screws, plastic, you know, bits and bobs. I'm not including all tool costs, but if you don't have tools, this is obviously going to be very expensive because you're going to either need to get it printed or made by someone else, or you're going to have to buy the tools, which I recommend buying the tools. So anyway, that gives us our total budget of about $900 Canadian so far. In the end, it could be less, it could be more, but for now it's $900. I'm assuming it's probably going to grow a little bit depending on if I get some more stuff or if something I find something's not working. But for now, $900 Canadian, 650 US, and about 600 euros, which I think is okay considering hopefully the product I'll be able to get out of it in the end, because the robot that I'm trying to get a comparable result to is like 2,000 euros, which is significantly more and also really difficult to buy. But yeah, that's kind of the end of this video. I'll try and keep you guys updated, but basically what I worked on is I made the budget document. I've got a rough design for the layout of the leg, and now I'm working on connecting the different pieces of the leg in a way where it's strong enough and it works. Yeah, so I will see you next week with hopefully a more refined version of the leg, and it probably won't have power yet because I haven't figured out where I can solder in my new place. But yeah, next week hopefully I'll have a new leg model and maybe a little update on budget, most likely not though. So see you next week with more robot stuff.